your name. Yes. We love your name. Thank you, Jesus. We love the name. Don't call. We love your name. We love your name. We love your name. Oh, we love your name. Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. God, we come to bless you.
Yes, Lord.
We come to praise you. Hallelujah. We come to say thank you again. We come to lift up your name. God, we thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank God for another week. Thank you, Lord, for another day. Hallelujah. Thank you for your mighty outstretched hand that have kept us alive another week, Lord. That blessed us to wake up this morning. God, from our slumber and our sleep. God, we come to praise your name today. We come to remind ourselves, God, just how good you've been to us. Thank you for the people of God today, Lord, that are gathered in this place. Thank you for every home today that's represented, oh God, in this room today. God bless this house. God bless this service. God bless the preacher. God bless the people of God. In the mighty name of Jesus. We remember your goodness, oh God. We remember your love and mercy. We remember where you brought us from. We remember how you brought us out. We remember how you made a way. And God, we come today with boldness to say thank you, Lord. Oh, bless your name. You didn't have to do it. Oh, God, but you blessed us anyway. You didn't have to redeem us. God, but you redeemed us anyway. You didn't have to make a way. But God, you made a way. Thank you, Lord, for the body that you touched. Thank you, Lord, for the soul that you saved. Thank you, Lord, for your mighty outstretched hand. Have you oh God, stretch out your hand. Stretch out your hand to save. Stretch out your hand to save. Stretch out your hand to heal. Stretch out your hand to deliver. In the mighty name of Jesus. God, we love you today. We pray for the people of God. We pray for our leaders today. Even where they are, oh God, that you would cover them. In the name of Jesus, Pastor Clerkley and Lady Clara, we cover you in the name of Jesus. Lord, let your grace and your blessings be upon our leaders, we pray today. Whoa, oh Lord, God bless the speaker, that man that will preach the word. Let the Holy Ghost rest on it, that the word of God might go forth in the name of Jesus. Oh, Jesus, bless the choir. Oh, Lord, bless the praise team. In the name of Jesus, let the grace of God and the anointing of God be on the musician today in the name of Jesus. God, we invite you in to come on in. Come on in and have your way. Come on in and let your glory be revealed. Come on in and let your spirit move. Come on in and let the Holy Ghost have the right of way. God, in the room right now. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, God, stretch out your hand today and have your way. In the name of Jesus, clap your hand and tell him thank you. Clap your hand and tell him thank you. Thank you, Father, for the mind. Thank you, Father, for the wheel. Thank you, God, for the opportunity to be in the house of God one more time. Well, thank you, Jesus. Oh, bless his name. Oh, bless his name. We come to bless your name. We come to sanctify him. Hey, Lord, you've been so good. Yes, Lord. And we thank you today. Have your way, Lord. All day long. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost in the room today. Ah, God, send your word today. Bless every heart that's here. Bless every soul that's here. Oh, God, if there's a sinner under the sound of my voice, don't let him leave the same way that he came. But let the gospel of Jesus Christ, which is the power of God, touch him right now and move on him to save, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Bring your children home, those that are backslidden in their walk, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Redeem, save, heal, in the name of Jesus, all day long. Dear God, have your way. Bless every mother. Bless every sister. Bless every elder. Bless the children. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God. Every home that's represented here. It might be the mother standing. It might be the father standing. It might be the child standing. But whoever it is, Lord, that's in the room right now, I'll send a blessing in the name of Jesus back to that home from which they came. God, meet every need in the name of Jesus. If there's a need of finance, God, meet the need. If there's a need of peace, God, meet the need. If there's a need for healing, Father, meet the need. In the name of Jesus, do it for your own glory. Do it for your own praise. Say yeah, up. Tell him thank you. Oh, God, we thank you today. Glory to your name. Ha! Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Thank you.
God, you're worthy of our praise. Ha! We enter into your gates with thanksgiving in our hearts, and into your courts with praise. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Everyone say, thank God.
Thank God.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Amen. Those of you that are able to remain standing, would you please remain standing and receive missionary Andrea Evans, who will give us our scripture for today, after which, again, if you are able to stand, continue to stand, for the Lighthouse Praise Team is coming. And saints, we're going to worship God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. God bless you.
Amen. Praise God. This morning, I honor the Lord this morning to Elder Mayberry, to all of you God's people. I will be reading Psalms 117, and it reads, oh, praise the Lord, yes. O ye nations. Praise him, all ye people, for his merciful kindness is great toward us, and the truth of the Lord endureth forever.
Yes.
Praise ye the Lord.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Come on, put our praise in the atmosphere.
Yes.
Come on, somebody needs your praise on this morning.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, I know somebody needs your praise this morning. Hallelujah. Come on, give it to God. Give it to God. Give it to God. Honor him. Hallelujah. Oh, we bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Now, why don't you praise God for somebody else? Hallelujah. Come on, praise it for somebody. Somebody who might be in the hospital. Somebody who might be at home. Somebody who might be in a nursing home. Somebody who might be in rehab. They may not be able to put their hands together. They may not be able to get out of the bed and walk. They may not be able to do a whole lot of things. But God said that we are supposed to bear one another's burdens. So if they cannot, and we can, come on, let's praise God on their behalf. Come on, give it to God. Give it to him. Hallelujah. Oh, bless his name. Hallelujah. Open up your mouth and hallelujah. And bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Hey. Hey. Hallelujah. Oh, bless his name. Hallelujah. Oh, bless him. Hallelujah. Oh, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Come on. Hallelujah. We're just going to believe God today. Hallelujah. For everything that he has promised. Whether we see it or not. Hallelujah. Because I just learned on this week. I really couldn't figure out, couldn't understand. But when God said to come to Lighthouse, I just came. Hallelujah. But what I found out on this week, just from talking to my grandmother, she's in the hospital. She had to go to emergency on Monday. I watched her as she was sick in the hospital. I watched what she was going through. But God saw fit to bring her out and to bring her through and to allow her to have surgery. But God allowed me just a space and time to just sit there and just listen to her. And she just wanted to talk. And she wanted to talk to me. She recognized who I was. And in the midst of her talking, she said that when she was going through with her family, hallelujah, way back before I was even thought of or even born, but I was in the midst of what was going on, hallelujah. And my grandmother said that she went to Pastor Calloway. And she said that she went to Lighthouse when it was in Altamisa. And she said that she listened to the old mothers teach her what to do and how to do. And my grandmother said that she did what the preacher said. See, they didn't take their business to the court. They took their business to the preacher and listened to the man of God give her direction. And when grandmama said she did what the preacher said to do, and she listened to the old mother. When I was on my way home, that thing hit me in my chest. I said, how awesome God is to bring me back to a place that I was birthed out of. Before I shake her. I said, God, you had me in mind even before I got here, in the midst of the trouble, in the midst of the storm, in the midst of the situation, you had the mothers at Lighthouse and the pastor of Lighthouse praying for me. And they didn't even know me. Hallelujah. So when the Bible says that the prayers of the righteous availeth much, oh, don't take it for granted. You may not even see who that child is. But if God gives you to pray for that child, pray for somebody's situation. Go ahead and pray. Because you don't know, hallelujah, your children might be a witness that there's going to be somebody coming up in here and saying, somebody's mama prayed for me. Hallelujah. I am a witness that God is faithful to his word. Come on, if you believe it, just give God glory. He's faithful to his word. I I don't know what petition you have before him, but trust him. You may not even see it, and you may not even know who it is. Your mama and them didn't know me. They not even here. You may have been sitting on the pew right next to them as they was praying for me. And here I am. Hallelujah. Saved, sanctified, delivered, set free, Holy Ghost filled, in love with God. Hallelujah. I thank you for your prayers. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and just tell him God is able. Come on, tell somebody God is able. Whatever you're going through, God is able. Hallelujah. Hey. Hallelujah. Listen. Exceedingly. Abundantly. Above all. You. According to the power that works in you. Look at your neighbor, tell him it's working in you. Oh, God is able to do just what he said he will do. Anybody believe it? He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Oh, don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you.
Oh,
He's able.
He's able.
To do exceedingly.
He's able.
Abundantly.
He's able.
Don't give up on God. I don't know about you, but I'm encouraged. Don't give up on God. Oh, no. Ooh. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. Do you receive that this morning? Hallelujah. Do you believe it? Hallelujah. Do you receive it? Hallelujah. 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 Yeah. Woo. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hey. I don't know about shake. I heard that. I heard that. Yeah. I heard it. Yeah, my shake. Say yes. If you receive what God is saying to you today, lift your voice and say yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Come on, let him blow your mind. Just tell him yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Come on, with hands lifted up. Come on, tell him. I receive it, God, got my job, yeah.
Yes.
Whatever is going on in my home, I tell him, yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah, come on, give it to him, give it to him. Let him have it, just tell him, yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah. My children, I just tell them, yeah.
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 Yes to your will.
Yeah.
Yes to your word.
Yeah.
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 Come on, lift those voices. I can't tell you what to tell God. I can't tell you how to interact with him. I can't tell you how to pull on his heartstrings. But I can tell you that a praise, hallelujah, woo, a praise will do a whole lot. Because he inhabits the praises of his people. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Tell him, yeah. Put those hands together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, put those hands together. Not because I asked you to. Hallelujah. 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 Hey. Hallelujah. Now listen, I want to do this for my grandmama. Because she was praying early this morning. I spent the night with her. And she started praying about the pain that she was in, but she was thankful that she was still alive. Oh, my grandmama, she can sing. She can, you know, bust out with a song. I just need y'all to put y'all hands together. And we gonna clap. Joy bells keep ringing in my soul.
Joy bells keep ringing in my soul.
Joy bells.
Joy bells.
she say, yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord, it's ringing in my soul. Oh, 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 it's ringing in my soul.
Yes, Lord.
I told you,
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 yes, Lord. your hands like that.
Bless you on today. Hallelujah. How about them joy bass? My God. Sister McCoy touched a little something on the side, inside of it. Hadn't heard that little song in a long time. How about the joy bass? Just keep on ringing. Even when I'm going through, if I just be still for a minute and begin to look back on what God brought me from. Oh, the joy bells start ringing all over again. Clap your hands today. Tell the Lord thank you. Thank the Lord, amen, for the praise team. Thank God for each of you that are gathered in the house of the Lord on today. Amen. Certainly we do honor our leaders. Superintendent Clerkley, Lady Clara, in their absence, and to Elder Edwards, Minister Wheat, Minister Brown, Elder Livingston, to all of, amen, the beautiful women of God, amen, that are present today, to my mother, who is present today, and most important of all, to that person that's the best thing that ever happened to me. Yeah, Sister Precious, thank God for each of you today, and may God smile on each of you that have chosen, amen, to come out to the house of God on today for to worship him. Yes. The Bible teaches us in the book of Hebrews not to forsake the assembling together of ourselves in the house of the Lord. Even when the pastor is not here, we need to assemble ourselves together in the house of the Lord. So I commend each of you whose faces I look upon, because it gives me the impression that you really love God. No matter who's at church, I'm gonna be there. Amen? So God bless each of you on today. Amen. We thank God for the service thus far. And at this time, we're getting ready for the acknowledgement of our visitors and our announcements by Sister Carrie Jones. Say amen for her.
Amen. Good morning. If you are visiting Lighthouse for the very first time, would you please stand and remain standing as we recognize you? If you are visiting Lighthouse for the very first time, please stand and remain standing while we recognize you. Let's give a hand, Lighthouse. Amen. 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 On behalf of the Lighthouse Church, we'd like to extend a cordial welcome to you on today. We hope something is said that will encourage you on your Christian walk. Our greeters are coming with a greeter's packet. Please, there's a card in there. Would you please fill that card out and leave it with an usher or as you come around the offering table? And once again, thank you for visiting with us at Lighthouse.
Amen.
Amen. I have two oral announcements, and then I will be back with some written announcements. One from Sister Hardiman, and then missionary works.
Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I stand on behalf of the prayer ministry team. We are getting ready for our second prayer walk. We had our first one here at Lighthouse, and it was beautiful. God moved in a mighty way. If you are here and you attended the first prayer walk, could you please stand just for a moment so the people can see? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We had a beautiful time.
The anointing moved. We took territory back in the name of Jesus. So God is ready for us to take some more territory. Because the devil is bringing havoc in this world today. Oh, God, thank you, Father. Yes, God, thank you, Father. So we have one coming up this Saturday. I believe it's going to be October the 17th at 8, starting at 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. So I'm sorry, to 9 a.m. So we're going to be walking for an hour. Come out. Who wants to come out? Let's take territory. It's going to be Keys Park. How many are familiar with the Keys Park area? And we're going to be meeting on the side where the library is on the corner. I think that street is called Pavilion. I'm not sure. But we're going to be meeting right there at the corner where the library is. So if you have any other questions, you can see myself, Sister Katrina Varnado, or Sister Sabrina Kemp, or Lady Calhoun, Missionary Works, for any questions that you have. So just come on out, Lighthouse. We need to take territory. Amen. It's a vital time right now, Amen. And God is calling us back to prayer. Amen. Hey, God. Yes, Father. So let's come on, be on fire for God, and let's take territory. Amen.
Praise the Lord, saints. Won't be before you long. Just want to talk also with regards to the ministry of prayer and the next level of consecration that we are about to embark upon starting midnight tonight. Everybody say midnight tonight. Midnight. Amen. So the next level of consecration begins at 12:01 tonight or Monday morning. It will be midnight tonight to 12 a.m. next Sunday morning. The consecration runs for 7 days. From October the 12th through the 18th. This is a liquid fast, amen? Hot or cold liquids, please no sodas or high sugar. You can plan your meals. You wanna puree veggies or fruit smoothies. You can drink hot teas. You can puree soups, veggies, blend your food, beans, stews, green foods, just puree those and have them as liquids. You can do slim fast, or boost nutritional drinks. Again, you wanna plan out your meals so that you have your prepared meals for the week. Please drink plenty of water during this season. We also wanna make sure that we're not just changing diet, but we wanna include prayer in our consecration. We're praying and reading our Bible for at least 1 hour every day, amen? And let the Lord speak to us in that. We'll also be on the prayer line on Thursday and Saturday night from 8 to 9 p.m. And if you need that number, please see us and we will get that number to you. And our purpose again is for God to prepare us during this season of warning that he's called the congregation to. We wanna make sure we cover our leaders, of course, and whatever assignment God gives you in your hour of prayer, amen? So again, tonight, if for those of you that feel led and wanna be a part of this, we're going on a 7-day consecration. It's just another dimension God has taken us to. Amen? And I don't want to miss what God is doing. How about you? Amen. So starting midnight tonight, liquid fast, and we have flyers out, instructions if you want to see us with that. We'll also have flyers after church with regards to the prayer walk. Thank you.
Amen. I have a few announcements. This comes from Mother Bernice Thomas, the Mother's Council. Please meet me after service next Sunday about the Christmas party. So this comes from Mother Bernice Thomas, and she wants the Mother's Council, not this Sunday, but next Sunday, to meet her after service about the Christmas party. Brother Clyde, the barbecue man, says get your order in early for Thanksgiving, smoked turkeys and hams. He can be contacted. You can inbox him on Facebook or at 972-201-6456. 972-201-6456. So if you want smoked turkeys or hams for Thanksgiving, get your order in early. I have this announcement. Let's see, it's coming from the Resurrection Body of Christ. You're cordially invited to celebrate our 11th year Founders Day and building dedication service in honor of our Bishop Eli Jacobs. The dates are October 23rd through 25th. The time is Friday, 7 p.m., Saturday, 6:30 p.m., Sunday, 4 o'clock p.m., and the location is Keith Boulevard. There is no street address, so I guess you would have to contact them to get the street address. The dress code is formal, the colors are black and white, and the theme is 1 Corinthians 4:15. I will have the flyer if anybody wants additional information on this dedication service. Lastly, there's no service tonight at Lighthouse, and please govern yourselves accordingly to the printed announcements that are in the program, and thank you. That's all I have. God bless.
Let's say amen for the announcement. We want to govern ourselves accordingly, especially the prayer walk, amen, the consecration, the fasting. If anyone have any questions about any of that, please see Sister Work. Amen. She mentioned a lot of different ways that this particular fast can be done. Amen. So see her if you need to. Also, the announcement that was made by Sister Hardeman about the prayer walk. Any questions about any of that, see one of those women, those sisters. Amen. All right. We are up to that part of the service where, you know, we very often, well, I can speak for myself. I ask God for a lot. I do. I don't beg it. We don't have to beg it. Because I never had to beg my daddy, my natural father, for anything. If he knew I was serious, he was going to find a way to give it to me. I knew I didn't have to beg. But I wasn't shy about asking my daddy for something when I wanted it. Amen? So if I need the Lord to touch my body, I don't draw back. If ain't nobody else praying for me, I pray for myself. Yes, I do. And believe God gonna touch my body because he loved me. And when can't nobody else help me? When can't nobody else help me? I've been in some situations where nobody else can help me. My God. I was surrounded in Los Angeles one time by a gang of Crips. And I owed every one of them some money. Didn't know what I was going to do. But the Lord sent a man to intervene and said, whatever he owe you, you, and you, come by my house and I'll pay you. If it hadn't been for that, I might not be here today. So I know God loved me enough so when I asked him for anything, I know God gonna do it. If I sin, the Bible says I have an advocate that's on my side. I'm not gonna go try to do no sin. I don't like that no more. Used to be a lot of pleasure. The Bible does say it's pleasure and sin. But I don't like that no more. New man on the inside. Looking for something brand new. And so God is so good until when it come to giving, when it come to tithing, when it come to offerings, don't nobody have to, they don't have to ask me twice. Amen. If I have it, I'm going to give it. And if I don't have it, I'm going to ask God for it so I can give it. The point being, God is so ready to bless us. He is always on hand to meet our needs. Let's not draw back on God when it come time for us to give, amen, to the house of God, to the service of God, amen? So after having said all that, Lighthouse, it is offering time. We're going to ask those men that are going to be serving today if they would come, if you would prepare your tithes and your offerings. Let every man give according to
Hey, we're up to, you know, all the service is good. But I have to say nothing like the word. Nothing like the word. That's what saved me. My God, it was the word of God that I heard that saved my soul. It's the word of God that helped me to understand what I needed to do after I got saved in order to continue to please the Lord in my new life. Takes the word of God. It sanctifies us, saints. It teaches us how to walk. It gives us hope in a dark day like this. It's the word of God. My God, the Bible says that heaven and earth will pass away, but the word of God will stand forevermore. And so we are blessed today to be here having this opportunity to hear the word of God. If there's a sinner in the room, you have an opportunity to hear the word of God and be saved. If there's a backslider, you have an opportunity to hear the word of God and know that he yet loves you. Amen? Amen. So, amen, before our restoration choir comes with the selection, I just want to say that this young man, amen, have y'all read y'all bulletin yet? Oh, so y'all already know. There's a JR on the end of that name instead of a SR. And that J probably stands for jubilant. Because he's a lot more jubilant than that fella who has the S at the end of his name for senior. I'm gonna figure out what that S stands for. But I tell him in private before I say it out here, he might get me. But anyway, we have a young man, a young preacher, a young elder. Amen. Amen. He is a wonderful young man, in my opinion. Since I've known him, approximately 10 years thereabout, I've watched him and I've watched him grow. Yes, I have. I've watched him develop. I've observed him when he was going through various situations. He wasn't afraid to tell us, amen, when he was going through, when he, amen, lost a home, lost the automobile, had an accident, or whatever was going on. He's never been afraid to share it with the people of God. But through it all, he's still here. He's still standing. He's still, amen, ready and willing to do what God has called him to do. He is not an elder in the chronological sense. He's a young man. But in terms of his title, he is an ordained elder in the Church of God in Christ. Oh, I was there when the late Bishop J. Noel Haynes laid hands on him and ordained him an elder in the Churches of God in Christ International. So that's who we have that's going to bring the word of God on today. In the person of Elder Michael Oliver Clerkley Jr. He's going to come, and he often come before us not as trying to be somebody else. He's just Elder Mike. And I want you to join me, saints, and pray for him. Pray for him. Amen. That God will give him the strength and that God will give him the word, and that God will use him to say to us today what the Spirit of God would have us to hear. At this time, I'm going to ask you to receive our restoration choir, and after they shall have finished their selection, everyone, please rest on your feet and receive the word of God and the man that will bring the word of God. Say amen for the choir.
There's so much in my heart.
Yes.
I want to say to you, Lord.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Oh, there's so much you are.
Yes, yes.
And so much you have done.
Yes. Hallelujah.
I think with a little help.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm gonna give it a try.
Yes.
So please forgive me, Lord, if I start to cry. To tell you
how I worship,
and
adore you Master.
Teach me
how to
honor
you
with my
Father, we thank you on today. God, we will bless you. God, we do bless you because you're the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. God, we bless you. God, we magnify you. We exalt your name upon high. Even now in the name of Jesus, we will bless you at all times. And your praises will continue to be in our mouth, oh God. Our soul shall make her boast in the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. God, we will magnify you, even now in the name of Jesus. Despite every situation, despite every circumstance, oh God, despite every illness, even now in the name of Jesus, we will bless you. Yes, God, because you're worthy. Even now in the name of Jesus, God, I ask, oh God, that you continue, oh God, to reside in this place, oh God. Abide with us, oh God. God, we ask for your grace even now in the name of Jesus. God, you have filled this place, oh God, with your people. God, that is wanting something from you. God, we ask, oh God, that you would anoint us for this time, oh God. We ask that you would anoint us for this purpose, oh God. We ask that you would anoint us for this assignment that you have given us on today. God, I ask, oh God, that you would touch my body, oh God. God, that you would give us the proper amount of energy, oh God. God, to give and to do what you would have us to do on today. God, if you tell me to say it, I'll say it. God, if you tell me I'll do it, I'll do it. God, if you tell me to pray for him, I will, God. God, tell me, and I will do it even now in the name of Jesus. God, so that you can get the glory, oh God, that you will get the glory. God, you spoke to someone on this morning, and you spoke to them when they woke up, and they pushed themselves out of the bed, oh God. And they didn't just come here this morning, oh God, just to look at us. But God, they came to hear a word from you. Even now in the name of Jesus, I ask that you will answer their prayers on today, oh God. God, we thank you even now in the name of Jesus. God, I ask that you will save the unsaved, oh God. Reclaim the backslide, oh God. Heal the sick even now in the name of Jesus. God, deliver, oh God, and set free. God, we pray these prayers in your son Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You may be seated. We first give honor to God, who's the head of our life. We thank God for being saved and filled with his precious Holy Ghost. We give proper honor to our pastor and the elect lady in their absence. Amen. It's proper to clap right there. We want to give honor to the most capable, and I've said it before, but I don't mind, and I love to reiterate it, but the most capable assistant pastor that I know of. I remember when Dad was talking, and Elder Father Mayberry went on to glory, and Dad was, we were just father and son just talking, and he was just talking, and you know, somebody's going to want to be second position, and somebody's going to, I said, Dad, I don't think none of us is ready. Honestly. I said, Dad, just leave it just like it is. There's nothing wrong with it. Let Elder Young just stay right where he is. Don't do it. And God called Elder Young home, and so we had that conversation again. And I said, Dad, out of all of us, it's got to be Elder Mayberry. I said, look at him. He ain't scared of nobody. He's staying flat-footed. Tell you to your face. If you wrong, if you right, he don't know. And, but he do it in such a loving way that I don't take it. I've asked him one time, I don't know if you remember, I wasn't ready to preach. And I told him, I said, I'm sorry, Adam Mayberry, I cannot preach this time. He said, son, you're going to preach. I said, but I didn't prepare, and I don't want to get in front of them. Well, just pray, but you're going to get up here and preach. Wow, you want me to get up, and I'm telling you I'm not ready. No, you're going to preach. Just pray, and God is going to use you. Yes, sir. And so I just thank God for a very capable. It's nothing. It's no slack on no one else, no other elders or anything. Please don't take it that away. But God has appointed him to assist our pastor, and he's very capable. And I believe that God spoke to pastor and gave him Elder Mayberry. So I just want to give you honor in your position. I do take it another way because you do stand next to my dad. So on the natural end, I trust you. I trust you with my dad. So I just give honor. And also to the assistant pastor's wife, missionary, precious, the precious Mayberry. Amen. Amen. God bless Sister Mayberry. I think most of us have seen missionary grow, boy. She I remember when I first got here, Elder Salters was the Sunday school. He would always tell us to bridge it together. And I would just remember Missionary Mayberry back then and the person she is now and how she have grown in the church, in the spirit, in the word. And so we just thank God for Missionary Mayberry, to all of these elders, to all of these saints, to all of these ministers, missionaries, to my own family, my wife and my children. We thank God for you. That was an announcement that was not made. The youth department wanted to make the announcement that on next Sunday, which is third Sunday, we wanted all the young people and youth workers to wear their school, high school colors. Oh, everybody. Everybody to wear, since it's Youth Sunday, everybody to wear their school colors or their school jersey or shirt, whatever it is, just to support the youth. High school, college, or whatever it is. Don't wear the same one that you used to wear, though. You can just go and buy a t-shirt. Don't pull that one out back. Don't pull that one. But you can go and buy a shirt that's the same color as the one that that you used to wear. But don't go original on us next Sunday. We don't. Back in the 80s, we used to wear the half cut-off shirts. Yeah, that's in the biking tights in the pouch. You remember that in the 80s? We're not going there next Sunday. But just wear a color. If you still have the exact original jersey still sitting in the No, we're not doing those. No. So we want to do that next Sunday. And I believe it was that it? And baked potatoes. The Daughters of Sarah is doing the baked potatoes next Sunday after church. So if you will, go ahead and get your Bibles and let's turn to the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 1. And then we will go to verse 13, 14, and 15. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 1, verse 13, 14, and 15. And I will go ahead and start reading. The Bible says, "It came to pass after this also that the children of Moab, the children of Ammon, and with them other beside the Ammonites, came against Jehoshaphat to battle." 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 13. "And all of Judah stood before the Lord with their little ones, their wives, and their children." 14. "Then upon Jezeel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benai, the son of Jael, the son of Mattaniah, a Levite of the sons of Asaph, came the spirit of the Lord in the midst of the congregation." Verse 15, "And he said," the prophet said, "Hearken ye all Judah and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou King Jehoshaphat. Thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid nor dismayed by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but it is God's." I would like to preach. You may be seated. I would like to preach this morning what I believe God has given us. The battle is not yours, but it belongs to God. The battle is not yours. Brother Clerkley, what are you saying? A battle is just an encounter with opposing force. Whenever there's a battle, there's an opposing thing or something that comes against what you're going for. But God is saying that this battle, that this fight that we're in, that this war that we're in, this attack, this struggle, do not belong to us. It belongs to him. This last week, and Pastor has proclaimed it over the house, that we are in battle. We are in war. And on last week, Sister Wyoming, when that situation happened in the church, I saw three types of people when that happened. Soon as that happened, in my natural eyes, I saw chaos. I saw people running. I saw people trying to see what's going on. You saw people talking. In my natural eyes, I saw chaos because I didn't know myself what was going on. People was asking, what's going on? You see, I saw people running, and some people knew exactly whatever their natural job was. Some people immediately, I saw Brother Jerome come down, run over. I saw the nurse, I forgot who it was. I saw some people with their natural instinct immediately jumped into action. And they immediately started doing. I saw some prayer warriors immediately started praying. I saw some prayer warriors immediately started walking and pacing back and forth. I saw someone right here walking back and forth. And then I saw someone on the wall. I know we talked about taking territory. I saw someone on the wall walking down the aisle. I saw people praying. But I also saw people like that was clueless. Because they didn't know what was going on. There was three types of people. People that were unaware of their surroundings. There was prayer warriors. And then there were people that started praising him before they even saw the results of what was going to happen. That was the three people. But then what happened was that the commander, the pastor, took from rest, stood up, and took his natural position. He came from his position, and he took what came natural to him. And he stood before the people and started proclaiming war in prayer. And then before he even knew what the outcome was, he started proclaiming the victory and told us to praise him before we knew what the outcome was going to be. We have to understand that the war that we're in, the battle, do not belong to us, but it belongs to God. And so when we look at this story, the story of Jehoshaphat, it was the victory over the Moabites and all of these ites and all of this. But soon as we see it, there was when Jehoshaphat comes on the scene. Jehoshaphat is a young leader that's about in his 30s. History says he's about in his 30s. And he goes and he starts leading the people. But then there was some issues with other leaders and his son and who his son was with. And there was different issues. But the enemy began to gather themselves and align themselves together to come and attack Jehoshaphat and God's people. But that's one thing that I saw was there's three things that we're going to talk about today. And it was where the enemy set up the attack, the response of the leader, and the results of corporate cooperation in battle. Where the enemy set up his attack, the response of Jehoshaphat, the leader, and the results of the corporate, because they came together, the corporate cooperation in battle. So when we look at where did the enemy set up, I don't know how to pronounce the word, but it was in the valley of E-I-N-G-E-D-I. And in this valley was set up outside the skirts of where Jehoshaphat and the people were. Yeah. And the enemy set up, they left where they were and came to set up territory to attack the people of God. Yeah. Now, this is significant because this place had a natural spring. Yeah. Now, I need you to catch this. Where the enemy came to attack the people of God, this place where they came flowed, had two natural springs that flowed that the people of God can always go to. Yeah. This place where it flowed, fishermen even partook at that place where they were able to make money and feed their families. This was a place that it was known for their vineyards. This was a place, it was an important source of expensive perfumes and where they can make money. This was a place that the enemy came and set up territory. Now, if I can bridge it, what happens now in the natural sense to us is that the enemy comes and sets up territory in places where it seems like that's where we make our money, your job, your house, your finances, church, you personally, your physical life. He comes and sets up so you cannot partake of that thing that you're used to partaking. And so he sets up ground and dares you to come and take it back. But I believe that the battle do not belong to us. The battle belongs to the Lord. The enemy came and set up territory upon the place where the people of God felt comfortable, where the people of God knew where they can get their source, their money from, the vineyards. The enemy came to purposely set up there. But then what was the response of Jehoshaphat? Jehoshaphat gathered the people, and the people, because he realized the battle was bigger than he was or the people. Jehoshaphat didn't take the position as, my name is Jehoshaphat and I'm the king, and how dare you come upon our territory. Jehoshaphat, when you look at verse 3, let's read chapter 20, verse 3 and down. It says, and Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaim a fast throughout all Judah. And Judah gathered themselves together to ask help of the Lord. Even out all of the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. And Jehoshaphat stood in the congregation of Judah and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court. And Jehoshaphat stood in the congregation of Judah and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court and said, O God, O Lord God of our fathers, art not thou God in heaven and rulest not thou over the kingdoms of the heathen? And in thy hand is there not power and might? Is that none is able to withstand thee? Listen to what Jehoshaphat, this is his prayer. He's talking to God. Art not thou our God who didst drive out the inhabitants of this land before thy people Israel and gave it to the seed of Abraham, thy friend, forever? And they dwelt there and have built thee a sanctuary therein for thy name, saying, if when evil cometh upon us as the sword, judgment, or pestilence, or famine, we stand before this house and in the presence, for thy name is in this house, and cry unto thee in our affliction, then thou wilt hear and help. And now behold, the children of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir, whom thou wouldest not let Israel invade when they came out of the land of Egypt, but they turned from them and destroyed them not, these same people. Behold, I say, how they reward us. We didn't even attack them. And this is how they reward us, to come to cast us out of thy possessions, which thou hast given us to inherit. O our God, wilt thou not judge them? For we have no might against this great company that cometh against us, neither know we what to do, but our eyes are upon thee. Some situations that we are facing, I don't need to tell you what's going on in your house, but your money cannot handle some of the problems that you're handling right now. Your education cannot take care of some of the things that you're going on right now. Some of your connections cannot take care of some of the things that you're going through right now. Some of this stuff, we're going to have to come together. We're going to have to pray together. We're going to have to praise together. Some of this attack that's coming in this season, you cannot do it on your own. You cannot do it on your own. I'm telling you. In this season, the attack that is coming up on the house, you cannot handle it on your own. In this season,
It's going to take us as a group of people to attack the enemy, to take it back. Whatever he stole from you, whatever he took from you, it's going to take us together to take it back because it belongs to you. I got to tell you that the devil is not playing. He's going to come on your ground and he's going to dare you. I dare you to fast and attack me. I dare you to get in your word and attack me. I dare you to put your face before the Lord and attack me. In this season, you can't do it on your own. It's going to take the help of prayer warriors. Prayer warriors, you can't do it on your own because it's going to take the help of the praisers. Praisers, you can't do it on your own because it's going to take the help of the worshipers. Worshipers, you can't do it on your own. It's going to take the help of the choir. Choir, you can't do it on your own. It's going to take the help of all of us. This battle that we're in, this battle belongs to God. God understands that we are not capable in this human flesh to face an enemy that we cannot fight. I believe it's a setup that God has did for us to turn to him. Yeah, he put us in situations just to set us up. And all of a sudden, your prayer life comes through. All of a sudden, you start praising. All of a sudden, you realize that God is important. It's all a setup so you can look up. Let's move to the results of corporate cooperation in battle. Yes, sir. The results of what happened during this battle of the cooperation of everybody. Yeah. Everybody had a role. Lighthouse, yes. Members and non-members. Yes. Whether you're in position or not in position. Whether you sing or don't sing, whether you're a prayer warrior or you're not a prayer warrior, whether you're a preacher or not a preacher, I got to tell you that you are on assignment yourself. God did not design you to come to this house to sit down just to look. You have assignment also. The results of the corporate cooperation in battle, let's look at verse 21. I will go ahead and start reading. In verse 21, it says, And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers. He appointed the sanctuary choir unto the Lord, and that should praise the beauty of his holiness. And they went out before the army and to say, praise the Lord for his mercy endureth forever. Verse 22, and when the sanctuary choir began to sing and to praise the Lord, look what the Lord did when the sanctuary choir started singing. Look what the Lord did. The Lord set ambushments with the S. What God did on Sunday was we saw something with our natural eyes, but God set up ambushments all over. And what happened was people started believing that it is possible. When Elder Mayberry came back with a report that she was healed, she was talking, people, because of the testimony, they started believing themselves. God set it all up He set the ambushment up against the enemy just so you can believe I am still God. I'm still God. I just had to use Sister Wyoming just to tell you and just to show you, because some of you don't believe that miracles still happen. Some of you don't believe that I can still heal. Some of you don't believe that I can still save. Some of you don't believe that I can still make a way out of no way. Some of you don't believe that I am God. Verse 24 says, and when Judah and when the praisers came toward the watchtower in the wilderness, they looked unto the multitude, and behold, there were dead bodies fallen to the earth, which were the enemies, and none escaped. Verse 25, and when Jehoshaphat and his people, when Superintendent Clerkley and the Lighthouse Church, when the pastor and the sanctuary choir, when the pastor and the nurses, when the pastor and the elders, when the pastor and the missionaries came together, what they saw was a desolation of the enemy. What they saw was a complete attack that was complete on the enemy. And what the people started doing was they started taking back. They started taking back, the Bible says, the spoil, the loot, the valuables, the stuff, my peace, yeah, my peace, my money. I'm taking it back. And the people of God saw that they had won. And so Jehoshaphat started to take back the precious jewels which were stripped off of the enemy. More than they could carry away. I like this one. The people of God, when the war was over, what God had did was set it up so the Bible says that he will open up a window, a season. Because when you think of window, you think of something so small. But it's not window in the sense of a window that's in our house. When he talks about windows, he talks about seasons. Yeah. There is this opening. He will open up this season for you, that he will pour out blessings that you will not have room to store. Look at what the people of God did. It took them 3 days. Can you imagine 3 days of blessings? 3 days of God, please give it to somebody else. God, I can't take no more favor. God, I can't take another raise. God, I can't take another promotion. God, you giving me so much. I feel like I'm not worth all that you giving me. You giving me so much. You giving me health. Look at me now. My knees can move. My heart is moving. I got the activities of my limbs. I'm not worthy. Look at me. Look what you're doing for me. Look how you bless me. Look how you raise me. He's going to give you so much that you will not have room to store. Now, verse 26 says, and on the fourth day, now it took them 3 days to gather up everything. And the Bible don't say this, but I believe this, that even though it took them 3 days, I believe that they still didn't take everything that was there. I believe there was residuals left when the people of God left everything there. But verse 26 says, and on the fourth day, they assembled themselves in the valley. And I don't know how to pronounce the word, but it's B-E-R-A-C-H. Barach. Baracha. Gotcha. In that valley. They assembled themselves at that place. For there they blessed the Lord. Therefore, the name of that place was called that name until this day. Now, when you look up that word, This word in Hebrew means to acknowledge God as the source of all blessings. And anytime in Hebrew, when they would do this, when they would go through their cultural rituals or traditions, and they would hear someone say this word, the response that was supposed to be given in Hebrew was amen. So in other words, when they bless, when you got blessed, you didn't go out to show off nobody. What you were supposed to do was go back and tell God, thank you. And when somebody heard of your blessings, they came back to confirm and said, amen. God bless me with a job, amen. God bless me with health, amen. God bless me with life, health, and strength, amen. God bless my home. God bless my marriage, amen. When one hears the words of God's blessings, our response is supposed to be in agreement, and that is amen. And so we have to understand in the word that God has blessed us. And in this season, God is going to do a new thing in our life. But you have to be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. And having done all the stand, the Bible tells us to stand therefore. And so we have to understand that it is the word of God that we're going to have to rely on in this time. It is the word of God that we're going to have to rely on in this battle. It is the word of God that we're going to have to rely on during this dispute that the devil will have against the people of God. The book of Psalms 18, chapter 18, verse 2 says, the Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer. My God, my strength, in whom will I trust? My buckler and the horn of my salvation and my high tower. I will call upon the name of the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. The chapter 20, verse 7 says, some boast in chariots and some trust in horses, but we will boast in the name of the Lord. Psalms 27 says that the Lord is the light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh. They stumbled and they failed. Though in hopes to camp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war shall rise up against me, in this will I be confident, that this one thing that I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. Please touch your neighbor and tell your neighbor, whatever it is you're going through, just remember, you're just passing through. Yes, Lord, just remember the trials that you're going through. You're just passing through. Just remember what you're dealing with. It's just only a test. It's time for us to trade it in. It's time for us to give it back to God. It's time for us to make a trade with our God. It's time for us to trade our sadness for divine gladness. It's time for us to trade your depression for divine intercession. It's time for us to trade our rejection for divine direction. It's time to trade your grief for divine relief. It's time to trade your despair for evening prayer. It's time to trade your disappointments for divine appointments. Yeah! Yes, Lord, I'm so glad that God did not give up. I'm so glad that God did not give up. I'm so glad that God sent his son down on earth to heal us, to save us. You got to realize that when you have Jesus, you have heaven's best jewel. When you have Jesus, you have God's son. When you have Jesus, you have Mary's baby. Joseph's stepson, Elizabeth's nephew, James and Jude's big brother, David's shepherd, Solomon's wisdom, Samson's power. You gotta realize that when you got Jesus, you got Jeremiah's bone in Gilead. When you got Jesus, you got Ezekiel's will in the middle of a wheel. When you got Jesus, you got Matthew's king, Mark's servant, Luke's great physician, John's word made flesh, the act coming of the Holy Ghost. When you got Jesus, you got everything that you need. When you got Jesus, yeah, yeah. When you got Jesus, you got everything. Yes, Lord. And the saints of old used to sing a song, be not dismayed, whatever, yeah, whatever betide you, God will, yes, Lord, God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide, God will take care of you. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, God, he did not give us the spirit of fear, but love, yeah, love, yeah, yeah, love, yes, Lord, love, yeah, and power, a sound mind. God, give us power to fight. God, give us power to have the victory. God, yes, Lord, God, yes, Lord, give us power, give us victory. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. The song says, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. I'm an heir of salvation. Yes, Lord, I've been purchased by God. Born, yeah, born, oh Lord, born of his spirit. I've been washed in the blood. This is my song, and I'm a praise. Yes, Lord, no matter what you go through, praise. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Yeah, praise him, magnify him, glorify him, lift him up, lift him up. Yeah, one more thing, and I'm out of here. One more thing, if you don't mind, grab your neighbor. Yes, Lord, grab a neighbor. Yes, Lord, mine, yeah. Grab your neighbor, yes, Lord, Lord, and tell your neighbor, this is how it feels, to hold the hand of a real survivor. Yeah, this is how it feels, to hold the hand of a real survivor. I should have been dead and gone, but the Lord made old death behave. The Lord, the Lord, yeah, yeah, the Lord kept me, the Lord delivered me, the Lord, yeah, the Lord saved me and delivered me, yes, Lord. The battle belongs to the Lord. Minister Craig gave us an analogy. It's on YouTube, but it was several years ago. But the analogy in the story was about a fisherman, a son and a father. And the son and the father went fishing one day. And the father told the son to do everything that I'm going to do. I want to show you how to fish, son. And so the father took the bait and put it on the end of the hook. And what the father did was he cast the bait into the water. So the son did what the father told him to do. But he noticed his dad did something different than he didn't see no other fisherman do. He said he started, after he cast, he started slowly just reeling it in. And then he yanked up on a fishing pole. And so the son immediately told him, Dad, that ain't what fishermen do. Why did you start reeling the fishing line in? He said, son, the fish know the difference between authentic and fake bait. And so as soon as I felt the tug on the other end of the line, I began to bring it in. In other words, he said that prayer is what we do. We cast our prayers. But that's not the end. You don't just pray and leave it alone. He says when you cast your prayers out, what you have to do is the devil understands what's authentic and he understands what's fake. And so when you cast your prayers out, what you have to do is put some constant movement with your prayers. And as soon as you feel a tug on the other end of the line, what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to pull and begin to move your bait in. Because on the other end of the line is your blessing. In other words, prayer is going to get the attention of your blessing. But it's your praise that's going to bring that thing in. So in other words, when you feel a tug on the other end of the line, you always got to make sure that there is constant movement with your prayers. Don't just pray your prayers amiss, but start praising God in advance. If it's a job that you're looking for, Lord, bless me with a job. And then you start praising him. If it's peace in your home, Lord, bless me with peace in my home. And then start praising him. If it's something in your relationship, you tell God to bless my relationship. And then you start praising him. Jeremiah, I don't think nobody got what I just did. Because every time I turn around, I look up and God keeps making a way for me. Every time I keep praising him and I turn around, God keeps doing new things for me. Every time I turn around, every time I look up, God keeps on blessing me. God keeps on making a way. Every time. We'll be right back.
trouble. I need the water's trouble. Terrazzo. Terrazzo. Come here. One more young person that's gonna stand and praise God. De'Aris. I need another young person that's gonna stand in that aisle over there. And I need one more young person to come over here and stand in this aisle. I need one more young person. Jemiah, stand over there. Of Jericho, but it wasn't until the sound of praise when the wall came down. You got to realize when Paul and Silas was locked up, it wasn't until the sound of praise that the chains was broken. You got to realize when they were in battle, as long as Moses' hands were down, they did not have the victory. But as long as Moses' hands was lifted, the people of God had the victory. I want my seasoned saints to be Moses. Because together we're taking back everything that the devil stole. If you're going to stand in your seat, your job is to keep your hands lifted. If you're going to stay there, your job is to make sure you keep your hands lifted. What you, Donovan, what you're going to do is you're going to give him praise with your mouth. And you're going to dance with your feet. You're going to praise him with your mouth. And you're going to give him praise with your feet. You're going to give him praise with your mouth, and you're gonna dance with your feet. You can stand in front. You're gonna praise him with your mouth, and you're gonna praise him with your feet. Jemiah, you're gonna praise him with your mouth, and you're gonna praise him with your feet. And the cooperation of us all together, some people ain't gonna even realize when they get home that things are different. Some people ain't gonna even realize that situations is gone. Some people ain't gonna realize that they already in the office talking about your raise. They already in the office talking about your promotion. They already talking about what they can do for you. So you in the seat. As long as your hands is down, we lose. As long as your hands are down, we lose. One, don't stop, don't stop. Two, don't stop. One, two, three, go. Let me hear you. Let me hear you. Let me hear you. Yeah. Victory. Victory.
anyone that wanted to come down for prayer, I ask that you would come down. While the water is troubled, while the Spirit of God is in this place, this is when we can ask what we want. This is the time we can ask what he will do for us when he is here. God is here. That ailment, that sickness, even now in the name of Jesus, come down. If you're walking down, come down with your hands up, because you already have the victory. Come down with your hands up, because you already get it in your mind. You already have the victory. You got to have it in your mind. You already, I got the victory. 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 Pray for these babies. I got the victory. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You got the victory. You have the victory. You have the victory. You can pray while you're at your seat. We have the victory. 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 We have the victory, saints. We have the victory, saints. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You have the victory. Don't let your past stop your future. What happened yesterday happened yesterday. Today is a new day. Don't let your past affect your tomorrow. Don't let your yesterday affect today. Today is a new day. God gives us mercy, brand new mercies every day. God, we thank you for another chance. God, we thank you for another chance. God, you didn't let me go out. God, we thank you for another chance. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. God, we thank you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You have the victory. You have the victory. Daughters, you have the victory. Sir, you have the victory. Yes, Lord. You have the victory.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for what you've done. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for what you're doing right now. Bless, Lord, in every heart. Bless, Lord, in every mind. Bless, Lord, in every body. In the name of Jesus. God, work a wonder. Work a wonder right now. Work a wonder in his will. Work a wonder in his mind. In the name of Jesus. Work a wonder, Lord, for the young lady in her heart and in her mind. Victory, victory in the name of Jesus. Salvation in the name of Jesus. Restoration in the name of Jesus. Revival in the name of Jesus. Bless now, God. Bless right now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let the saints of God begin to clap your hands all together the preacher talked about doing things in unison. And he said every one of us had a part to play. I ought to see everybody clapping their hands on that. Clap your hands and tell him thank you. All at the same time. Let God see our movement and hear the sound of our voice. Telling him thank you, Lord. Thank you for what you have done on today. Hallelujah. God is still in the blessing business. Hallelujah. And we thank God for each of these that came down on this morning, this afternoon now. And God bless your hearts. God bless your souls. If you came down for prayer, go in faith. Go trust in God. The victory is already yours. Believe it in the name of Jesus. I declare that it's yours. Stand on it. Testify of it. Tell somebody else about how the Lord gave you the victory over that situation, whatever it may have been. Lay claim to it. Don't wait till you feel different, but just begin to praise God. Hallelujah. Anyhow, glory. That is the way of faith. Praise him anyway. Hallelujah. And so shall you see the results. Thank you, Lord. Thank God. There may be somebody here, amen, that would like to make Lighthouse your church home on today. We want to extend that opportunity and open the doors of the church. If you don't have a place of worship, I said earlier, the Bible teaches us in the book of Hebrews not to forsake, to assemble ourselves together. We all need to be a part of a body of believers, for that is where we will find our strength. Talks about how the hand can help the feet and the feet can help the rest of the body. Amen? All fitly joined together. If I got an itch, I thank God for my hand. My God, I can scratch. So we all need to be a part of a body of believers. If there's someone here today and you don't have a church home, you want to make Lighthouse your church home, we open the doors of the church. You might be visiting today and you don't want to become a member, but you'd like to kind of hang out here around Lighthouse for a while. Care. If that's your situation, we want to give you that opportunity. Amen. Saints, again, can we give God a hand clap? I know that we sometime in church get a little tired of standing up and sitting down, clapping hands, saying amen, slapping high fives. Yeah, we all get a little tired of it. But hey, thank God we're able to do it. Amen. Thank God I'm able and have a mind and a will to be in the church house clapping my hand. Amen. It's a blessing, whether you realize it or not. It is a blessing. Now, the young man said that Brother Mayberry told him, you going to preach.
But I ain't ready to preach, Brother Mayberry.
No, you going to preach. Now, way back then when I had that conversation with him, I just felt an urge to tell him. I kept telling him. I ain't got no better sense than if I feel like God is telling me to say something, it might not make no sense, but I say it anyway. I even laid on and said, Lord, why you put him on the spot like that when he said he didn't? But today, we kind of got a revelation of what God was saying, didn't we? Did he preach? Hallelujah. Thank God for the man of God. Thank God for the word of God that did go forth on today. The battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. In a day and a time like this, when we see what we see in the world, when we see the activities of the forces of darkness, It's a blessing to know that the battle is not ours, but it's the Lord's. Amen. Can't nobody beat him. Amen. Can't nobody beat God. And it's just good to be on the winning side, on God's side today. May God bless you on today. Certainly we are glad for all that God has done. At this time, we're going to get ready. Amen. We're going to ask those men that are serving today. Amen. We're going to get ready to go into our communion. Amen. We're going to ask all those brethren. Amen. If you would take your positions. Amen. We're going to get ready to have our communion. And we'll be ready to let you go. Amen. There will be no service here at Lighthouse on tonight. Amen. We look forward to seeing you on Tuesday night. Family life. Amen. Praise God.
And the word of God comes to us, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, beginning at verse 23. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he brake it, and said, Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup when he had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he comes. And now, Father, we're remembering. We're remembering, God, the nail-scarred hands in your feet, Father. Remembering the piercing of your side, Father. The thorns on your head, God. Father, we thank you, Father. We thank you for the blood of Jesus, God. For, God, we were destined for a sinner's hell, God. But because of your love for humanity, God. Because of your love for us, God. You plead our case, God. And the response was case dismissed, saved by grace. Father, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your kindness, God. We thank you for the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior and our soon coming King. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
For me. majesty.
Seated in majesty.
You are the risen.
You are the risen King. Majesty, you are the risen King.
You are the
seated in majesty.
You are the risen King.
You are the risen King.
Death could not hold you down.
Death could not hold you down.
You are the risen King.
You are the risen King.
Seated in majesty.
Remember this, that same night in which the Lord was betrayed, he took bread, he blessed it, and then he broke it up. He said, this is my body, it's broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And after the same manner, when supper was over, he took the cup. He said, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. It's shed for you. Do this and remember me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you recall, you remember my death until I come. May the Lord bless you. We thank God that we have celebrated the communion of our Lord. There will be no service here at Lighthouse on tonight. However, we look forward to seeing you on Tuesday night. Please continue to pray for our leaders. Pray for Pastor Clerkley, Lady Clara. Remember to pray for those that are sick,